So here we are at another campsite, just trying out a new system this time. It's a 3x3 meter ultralight tarp. So just got a few pieces of tree branch standing to hold the thing upright. And here's another large tree branch in the middle. And we've set up like a tripod system around it of other branches just to support it. There's Christina's shoes and gaiters hanging up. So also during the night we kept our food hanging up outside off the ground just to keep it away from those animals. There's my backpack. So it's a pretty good quality tarp. Has 8 different guy lines and they're all tied to trees. So that one's tied to that tree branch there. So there's our cook set, carrying 2 MSR dromedaries, one 10 litre and one 4 litre. So just take you for a walk around the back here, see what it looks like from behind. So we're camped directly on a walking track here. It's a very overgrown walking track actually. Just go for a quick walk up here so you can see just how overgrown it is. Lots of fallen trees. And it gets worse and worse up that end. But we did come from this direction. Just take you back down. So last night, the temperature was about 5 degrees. Inside the tent, it was about 7 or 8 degrees. So it's a bit warm in there because we have a piece of EVA foam on the ground, just reflecting the heat back up. So the tarp is standing quite high off the ground, but because we're in a valley here, there's very little wind. Last night there wasn't really any wind at all, but if it was a very windy night, you'd either have the tarp pitched much lower, or alternatively you'd use a vestibule. So a tarp set up like this is not really suitable in extreme wind. So let's just go for a walk down to the water source. So we camp next to a creek. Now, if it was raining heavy or if it was winter, you'd have to sort of think twice as to whether you're going to camp so close to a creek. The tent is about 2 meters above the height of this creek. So you might not believe this, but I'll just show you what's in this creek. I've got my spoon here. It's going to take a little sample of soil and just show you what I found here. Signs of copper pyrites there. And believe it or not, there is alluvial gold in this creek. So it's actually, believe it or not, a pretty common sight in the mountains of Australia. And we are only about 30 kilometers from an official gold mining town here. Quite difficult to pick it up there. You'll just have to take my word for it. There is alluvial gold in this creek. So if you want to do gold mining, you need a prospector's license. Unfortunately, we are in a national park, so gold prospecting is not allowed. But if you did find a nice spot and you're very patient and you're willing to spend, say, a couple of days on your knees panning for gold, you might be able to take home an ounce. But bear in mind, we are a 15 kilometer walk from the nearest dirt road, and that dirt road is extremely rough. So the old European settlers of Australia discovered the hard way that panning for gold is hard work. It does pay off for some. I'm not condoning illegal gold mining in any way. We are just here for sightseeing and making these videos. So just a little bit more about the tripod system. So I'll just show you how I made this so you can have some ideas of your own. So in the center of the tripod, you just wrap a heap of rope around. Just take it around so you can see it. There it is. So you just wrap a lot of rope around the top of the tripod to hold it up. So this particular piece of wood here I was using as a trekking pole yesterday. So in the bush, there's really no need to bring in commercially made trekking poles. You can just use pieces of tree branch. And the best thing about using tree branches as trekking poles is once you get sick of carrying the trekking pole, you can just dump it and then further on down the trail, pick up another tree branch and use that for your next trekking pole. So for all those gold prospecting hopefuls out there, we'll just go for another quick walk down to the creek, finish off this video. Thanks for watching. More campsites coming, and we hope we'll have something interesting to show you next time. Since colonisation in Victoria in the 1800s, more than 80 million ounces of gold have been found by prospectors, including the world's largest nugget, the Welcome Stranger.